हेलो एवरीवन, इन दिस वीडियो वी लर्न अबाउट प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना। सो एज यू ऑल नो, इट वाज अनाउंस्ड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर मिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी इन हिज इंडिपेंडेंस डे स्पीच। कि बिफोर वी गेट इनटू व्हाट जनधन योजना इज, लेट अस लुक एट द स्टेटस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन बिफोर जनधन योजना। हाउसहोल्ड्स विद बैंकिंग सर्विसेज अमाउंटेड टू अराउंड 60%, यू कैन से। रूरल हाउसहोल्ड्स विद नो बैंक अकाउंट amounted to 44% and urban households with no bank account is 33%. So as you can see, it was a very sorry state of affairs as far as financial inclusion in terms of opening of bank accounts was concerned. A lot of people in India had no access to bank accounts. Similarly, 95% adults in the 256 districts of India did not have access to bank loans. 95%, which is a very, very huge number, as you can see. Also, if you can see, the personal loan accounts were 55 million compared to the agriculture loan accounts, which were only 52 million. So you can see that personal loan accounts are higher in number than agriculture loan, even though agriculture supports majority of our population. And obviously, as you would know, that personal bank accounts, loan accounts are vastly in the cities. So first of all, the loan services overall were not available to the citizens of this country. And also, whatever services were available were heavily skewed in favor of the people living in the cities. So then came Jandhan Yojana. Jandhan Yojana is looking at financial inclusion in totality. So it's looking at three things rather than just opening bank accounts, which was the focus of all the earlier schemes. Now we're looking at three things. The first is opening of bank accounts. But it does not stop at just that, because Jandhan Yojana realizes that this is only one aspect of financial inclusion. The other two are access to credit and financial literacy. Basically, the idea of financial inclusion is to provide banking and other credit related facilities to the individuals of a country at low cost. That is, in very simple terms, what financial inclusion is all about. Now, for these services to be available to the people, they should also know how to use those facilities. That is where financial literacy comes in. So the people should first have access to bank accounts, they should have access to credit, and also they should have financial literacy to be able to use these products. Only then will we say that there is proper financial inclusion and people of this country are being benefited by banking services in totality. So this is the focus of Jandhan scheme in looking at financial inclusion in these three terms. So Jandhan Yojana runs in two phases. The first phase, which runs from 15th August 2014 to 14th August 2015, so in a span of 1 year, the target was universal access to banking facilities, at least opening bank accounts, this means. Also, the government is to launch a financial literacy program. And in terms of credit, you can read the last point, it is to provide basic banking accounts with overdraft facilities of Rs. 5000 after 6 months. So, after 6 months of starting a bank account and having some money in it would give the people an access to an overdraft facility of Rs. 5000, which effectively means they can take a loan of Rs. 5000 without too many questions asked as to why they're taking the loan. It's just an overdraft facility. They can take this money, use it for whatever purpose, and then they can repay it back to the bank. Also, they get RuPay debit cards with an intimate accident insurance of Rs. 1 lakh and a RuPay Kisan credit card. So again, this means that, because we said the people should get access to all financial services includes bank accounts, it includes loan or credit, it also includes insurance. So which is another thing which the people of this country have really been bereft of. They have not had a lot of insurance facilities in the past. So this Jandhan Yojana accounts enable them to get accident insurance cover of rupees 1 lakh, which is a very, very distinguishing feature which separates this scheme from all the earlier schemes that have been launched for financial inclusion. Also, it again links the RuPay Kisan credit card also, on which the farmers can take loans, agriculture loans, on easy terms. Now, as you can see, the basic thing is that Jandhan scheme, Jandhan Yojana, is trying to provide all sorts of financial services to the people under one roof. So it's not that you launch one scheme for opening bank accounts, then you open or launch another scheme for loans, then you have another scheme for insurance. What happens is the beneficiaries get divided and the beneficiaries cannot get the advantage of all the schemes under any one particular scheme. So a lot of people get left out in various schemes. But this scheme is trying to integrate all possible financial schemes into one, basically one black box, which will provide all these things to the beneficiary. So which is the distinguishing feature of this scheme? Now in the second phase, which is to run over 3 years, first of all, we have a creation of credit guarantee fund for the coverage of defaults in overdraft accounts. Now, as you mentioned, in the first year, there will be overdraft accounts. So people can borrow 5,000 rupees. Obviously, not all of these people will be returning the money. So the banks would run into losses. So to cover those, there is a credit guarantee fund, which will be opened by the government of India. It will be guaranteed by a central government organization for the coverage of defaults in the overdraft account, so that the banks don't have to suffer in case there is a default by people. Also, another banking or financial service is micro insurance. So insurance of small amounts or for small things. Again, this is a sector which has been very, very neglected in the country till now. And in the second phase of Jan Dhan, the government is thinking of targeting this aspect and providing small insurance covers to the people. Similarly, as you would know, that there are pension schemes for the organized sector. There is the new pension scheme for new government employees. There are the pension schemes for old government employees. But in the unorganized sector, there is nothing like that. So the people in the unorganized sector, the people who are working there, do not get the benefit of any pension schemes, and which obviously means that they are bereft of any social security scheme, which is very, very important for a life with dignity after your retirement. So the government is targeting an unorganized sector pension scheme. Like, there used to be a scheme like Swavlamban. I would not get into details here, but you should just know that there will be pension schemes for the unorganized sector. Again, a financial service which has not been really present in the country till now. Again, I cannot stress on this point further. Jan Dhan Yojana is trying to bring in all financial services sector schemes into one bouquet and then providing the people with all sorts of facilities right under this one scheme. Okay, so just to summarize, the objective of the scheme is to have at least one saving bank account for every household, providing financial literacy, access to credit and insurance and pension facilities. The benefits to poor include benefit of saving banks account, so they can save more, they can have an organization of their savings, need-based credit, remittance facility and insurance and pension. Now, as far as the implementation is concerned, the government is providing for 50,000 additional business correspondents who can go to people and open their bank accounts and help them operate the bank accounts. More than 7,000 new branches of banks will be open and more than 20,000 new ATMs will be installed so that the people can take advantage of these bank accounts, or the new bank accounts that are being opened. Now, what happened with the earlier schemes? This is not the first time that any bank account scheme or financial scheme has been launched. So what used to happen was the accounts that were opened under any financial inclusion schemes remained dormant, which led to high cost for banks and also obviously no benefits to the beneficiaries. So they practically remained zero balance or very low balance accounts, which basically benefited nobody. So this time the government is thinking to change that. And how they are planning to do this is that all the government benefits will be channelized to the people through these accounts. So the direct benefit transfer schemes will be channelized through these Jan Dhan Yojana accounts. So payments of MGNREGS and also the subsidies of LPG will be channelized through these bank accounts, which will ensure that there is always money in circulation in these bank accounts so that they do not become dormant. So this is again, you can see the thinking of the policy makers is to find out why, if there is a problem of dormant bank accounts, how can the government link its other services with this so that these accounts don't remain dormant. So this is a very good initiative, I think. Now, there are various benefits to the account holders. First of all, apart from the account that you're getting, there are various other schemes, benefits that you get. First of all, you get the RuPay debit card. So this is a smart card based thing which the beneficiary account holders can use to operate the bank account without the help of other people. Similarly, till now, all the schemes that came were focusing on geographical areas. So they used to try to focus on providing banking services to a village. But this is the first time that the focus of any scheme is the household. So here we are trying to provide one bank account per household. So this again will be offer a lot of benefit to the account holders. Also, it has inbuilt accident insurance coverage, as I just mentioned. It has zero balance, which this is not really a very unique factor. They've already been schemes where zero balance accounts have been opened, but this is again a good thing which has been incorporated in this scheme as well. And also, you can take the loan after 6 months of operating of these accounts, as I mentioned earlier. So these are various benefits that will accrue to the account holders. With the increasing bank accounts and increasing financial usage in the economy, there are various benefits that will accrue to the economy. First of all, there's cash flowing to the banking sector, so which can be used for various productive purposes like lending to the productive sectors of the economy and other things. So this is going to help in the growth of the economy in the long run. So that is the first benefit. Second is increased awareness of financial services. Through this scheme, the government is trying to increase the financial literacy of the population, which is very important for anyone to be able to save from their earnings and also to invest them wisely and to have benefits of any financial service. It is important to have financial literacy, which eventually is going to lead to better growth in the economy as a whole. So again, this is a benefit to the people but also to the economy. Secondly, faster and efficient benefits transfers. It'll plug leakages. It'll help in efficient funds transfer. All this is going to increase the efficiency of the economy, which means that effectively you'll get more bang for the buck. So each rupee that the government spends, there'll be more benefits accruing to the people and to the economy. And obviously, it's needless to say, with more bank accounts, savings will be mobilized, and because of which you can understand that if there are more savings, they can help in more capital formation in the long run, and which will lead to higher growth rate. So just to give you some data on the achievements under Jan Dhan Yojana, there've been 111 million bank accounts that have been opened. This was the data till Jan 12th. There have been approximately 9,000 crores of savings mobilized, and there have been 94 million rupee credit debit cards issued. So as you can see, these are very impressive numbers, and you should have an idea of, ballpark idea of these numbers, just to have a, basic idea. So, but there are still some gaps which remain. First of all, the credit to small borrowers. This scheme has a lot of features on paper, but what it seems to be, is how it pans out in reality. So, once the account is operated at a satisfactory level, only then some of these credit schemes kick in. So, the credit of 5,000 rupees or the other schemes also kick in once you operate the account at a satisfactory level. Now, it remains to be seen whether this is done by the people or not, or whether if they again become dormant, then the credit to small borrowers, that thing will not materialize. Secondly, when we are trying, these are basically last mile connectivity issues. So we need to take the credit and banking facilities to the last man in the village. So this might require structural reorganization of banks, because right now we have a model wherein we have large banks with smaller branches, but overall the banks are very large, so they are catering to the demands of very large customers also, and now we want them to cater to the demands of very small customers also. So sometimes it's structurally not possible or economical for them to be able to do this. So there might be some thinking in the policy quarters at a later stage wherein smaller banks could be envisaged to basically cater to this particular segment of rural people or with very small financial needs. Another thing is the gender gap. In the new accounts opened, the female to male ratio has been 394 to 1000. So, and certain states are lagging a lot in this, including Odisha and even Gujarat. So, it is very important that the females of this country do not get left behind in financial inclusion, because as they say, if you give or empower a man, it's probably that he alone benefits. But if you empower a woman, it's not only the woman but the entire family that benefits, and with the help of the family, the entire village, the entire society, the entire country benefits. So it is extremely important that this issue is taken up in policy quarters, and a lot of emphasis is laid on opening more and more female bank accounts. So this was an overview of the Jan Dhan Yojana. Thank you for watching. Hope you like the video. Comments and suggestions are welcome. Thank you.